More news overseas. Rescue operations in India resume to reach at least 40 men trapped for 5 days inside a collapsed highway tunnel. Authorities are trying to advance drilling machine, hoping it would speed up the rescue at the site in the Indian state of Uttarakhand. The plan is to drill and create a space for a pipe that can be used by the trapped men to crawl into safety. Authorities have not said what caused the tunnel to cave in, but the region is prone to landslides, earthquakes, and floods. The Israeli military says it uncovered a Hamas tunnel shaft and a vehicle with weapons at Gaza's Al-Shifa hospital complex. It made videos and photographs of the tunnel and weapons public, but no independent verification was possible. It also said the body of an Israeli woman who was taken hostage by Hamas was recovered by troops in a building near the hospital. Israel believes a vast underground Hamas command headquarters was operating in tunnels beneath the hospital. The militant group has denied the accusations. Widespread diseases and hunger inevitable in Gaza. That stern warning comes from the United Nations, citing growing cases of several diseases amid the lack of clean water in the Strip. The UN once again calls for fuel and aid delivery to the war-torn enclave to prevent further collapse of sewage and healthcare systems in Gaza.
The total depletion of fuel supplies is imminent, according to UNRWA. And it would be catastrophic across all of Gaza, leading to the complete collapse of water, sewage, and crucial healthcare services, and ending the trickle of humanitarian assistance that has been permitted to date. Massive outbreaks of infectious disease and hunger seem inevitable.
The European Union urging Israel to rethink its response to the brutal attacks of Hamas. EU Foreign Policy Chief Josep Borrell tells Israel's foreign minister, one horror does not justify another. Since Hamas militants stormed Israel on October 7th, over 11,000 Palestinians have been killed in Israel's offensive in Gaza. But Borrell says while Israel should defend itself, protecting civilians should be prioritized.
I understand your rage, but let me ask you not to be consumed by rage. I think that that's what the best friend of Israel can tell you. Because what makes the difference between a civilized society and a terrorist group is the respect for human life. And all human lives have the same value. And ultimately, security can only come from peace.
Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our chief bureau chief correspondent, TJ Manotok.
Good morning to our friends at The Rundown. Here are the top stories making the headlines.
We head to Los Angeles, where the exhibit of Filipino-American artist Paul Pfeiffer opened at the Museum of Contemporary Art. For the next 7 months, the museum will house Pfeiffer's deconstructed pieces, artistically placed throughout some 30,000 square feet of museum space.
This is a legendary institution founded by artists and a legendary space that's had an incredible history of really important groundbreaking exhibits for decades. So it means a lot. It's a big space to take on for an art exhibition.
Pfeiffer was born in Hawaii and had spent his childhood in the Philippines. He's now based in New York and continues to showcase a mixed medium of art through photo, sound, film, as well as vintage video and even wood. Pfeiffer's exhibit runs until June with other special events and programs taking place as museum goers take a look and listen at its world, both small and stadium size. And finally to New York, where another PhilAm artist is making her mark at the Big Apple. Amita Humez's mural featuring the popular Filipino dish sinigang was unveiled on November 14 in Brooklyn. The public mural on the wall of Arlo Hotel is located in the Williamsburg neighborhood. It celebrates Asian American cuisine, culture, and the power of authentic food.
The mural obviously is a collaboration with Noor. I wanted to really highlight what is it, how is it connected to me and like my family? And so the central figure is a woman that is representative of my own mom and a dish that she makes all the time called sinigang.
Hume says she drew inspiration from her Filipino mother for a work of art.
I always think about my mom when I think about Filipino food and the memories I had sharing it with her and cooking with her and having her teach me all of her little tricks.
New York City is home to many artists who make building walls their blank canvas. NYC is also home to the first Filipino elected to office State Assembly member Stephen Raga, who attended this Taste of Home event.
Knowing that this is bigger than the one we even have in district in Little Manila and Woodside, I'm pretty sure this is the largest Filipino mural in the state. So happy to see the unveiling here. It's an honor.
Hume says she loves being able to appreciate differences and share a meal that speaks louder than language barriers.
And those are the stories making the headlines in the North American region. For more of our TFC News, log on to our website, news.abs-cbn.com/TFCnews. Head over to the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel and download our app for your smartphones and tablets. I'm TJ Manotok. Back to our friends at The Rundown.